We want to find the average rate of change of f of x equals 3x squared minus x on the closed interval from 2 to t. So what's different about this example is notice the interval contains a variable. But we'll follow the same steps. To determine the average rate of change, we'll find the change in output, which is the difference in the function values or y values, and we'll divide by the change in input, which is the difference of the x values. Notice from this last formula here, we should recognize that determining the average rate of change is the same as determining the slope between two points. So we'll start by finding f of 2. That would be 3 times 2 squared minus 2. Well, 2 squared is 4 times 3 is 12. 12 minus 2 is 10. So f of 2 equals 10, which means when the input is 2, the output is 10, or if it were 2, we could express this as an ordered pair, meaning when the x-coordinate is 2, the y-coordinate is 10. And now we'll find f of t. So we're just going to replace x with t, so we'd have 3t squared minus t. So when the input is t, the output is 3t squared minus t. Or again, if we wanted to, we could express this as an ordered pair. When the x-coordinate is t, the y-coordinate will be 3t squared minus t. And now we have the information we need to find the average rate of change. We'll first find the change in the function values, or y values. Let's go ahead and get this information from our ordered pairs. Well, the outputs or function values are the same as these y coordinates here. So we'd have 3t squared minus t minus 10. Then the change in the input, or the change in the x values, would be t minus 2. We do want to try to simplify this, so let's see if we can factor the numerator. If it does factor, it'll factor into two binomial factors. The factors of 3t squared would be 3t and t. We want the factors of negative 10 so that the sum of the inner and outer product would be negative 1t. Notice if we put a negative 2 here, that would give us negative 6t. The other factor of negative 10 would have to be positive 5, so we'll put plus 5 here. So negative 6t plus 5t does give us negative 1t, so it does factor. And notice how we have a common factor of t minus 2, so this simplifies to 1. So our average rate of change is just 3t plus 5. So the average rate of change on the closed interval from 2 to t is equal to 3t plus 5. What this means is, for any value of t greater than 2, we can use this formula here to determine the average rate of change for that interval. So for example, if let's say t equals 3, on the closed interval from 2 to 3, the average rate of change would be 3 times the value of t, which is 3, plus 5, equals 14. So on this interval, the rate of change would be 14.